morning students, how are you all? Is everyone fine at home? Yes, okay. So let's begin to our class. In your previous class, what you have studied, what we have studied about division of positive and negative integers, right? So we saw how to divide negative integers also. So now in today's class, we are going to see what is a square and a square root, okay? And how to find the square and a square root of a number, okay? So, if I take a number 6, okay? So, and if I have to find its square, so finding a square means what? We have to multiply the given number 2 times, okay? If we are talking about the square, then we have to multiply the given number by itself 2 times, okay? So, if I multiply this number 6 to itself 2 times, okay, 6 into 6 if I do, then 6 multiplied by 6 is 36, okay. So this 6 multiplied by 6 can be written as 6 raised to the power 2, okay. This is, this we can read this as 6 raised to the power 2, or we can say that 6 square, okay. So this means that 6 raised to the power 2 is equal to 36. This is read as 6 square is 36, okay? So we say that 6 square is 36, okay? Okay, so we say 6 square is 36, or we can also say that the square of 6 is 36, okay? So we read this in two ways. First one is we say that 6 square is 36, okay, 6 square is 36, or we call it as the square of 6 is 36, okay. Now, this is, I have written 6 square is equal to 36, okay. But if this square goes to the other side of equal to sign, okay, if here it is on the left side, right. Now, if it goes to the right hand side, then the square sign, after coming to the right hand side, it becomes a square root, okay, and a square root sign is like this, okay. So after the square goes to the right hand side, it becomes a square root, okay, and the here only 6 remains now, okay. So this we say that the square root of 36 is 6, okay. This is read as square root of 36 is 6, okay? That means a square of a number means what? A square of a number means if we multiply a number to itself 2 times, then we say that the number which is obtained is the square of the given number. That means 36 is the square of 6 here, okay? Or if we want to find the square root, that means if 36 is given to us and we have to find the number which after squaring becomes 36. So if 36 is given to us, then by squaring it, by putting the square root sign, we get 36. Then how do we get this, how do we know that which number multiplied to itself gives us 36? That we need to recall, okay, which number multiplied to itself will give me 36, okay. So that after recalling, we say that when we multiply 6 to itself 2 times, we get 36. So the square root of 36 is 6. Similarly, if I have to find the square root of a number 9, okay? So if I have to find the square root of 9, so first I need to check which number multiplying with itself will give me 9, okay? So tell me which number after multiplying, which number multiplying to itself will give me 9, okay? So which number multiplied by itself is equal to 9? Which is it? 3, okay? 3 multiplied by 3 is equal to 9, okay? So we say that 3 square is equal to 9. Or we can write this as square root of 9 is equal to 3, okay? So this was an example of 6, number 6, 6 square is equal to 36, and the square root of 36 is 6. This is read in this way, okay? Now similarly, 3 square is equal to 9 or square root of 9 is equal to 3. Okay? So these are inverse operations. Okay? When the square sign goes from left hand side to the right hand side, then it becomes a square root. And if the square root sign goes from left to right, it becomes a square. Okay? So everyone has understood how to find the square and square root of a number. Now we see that square and square roots can be negative also. Okay, so that we will see now. So now we saw that 3 multiplied by 3 gives me 9. Okay, but similarly if I multiply minus 3 two times. Okay, if I multiply minus 3 by minus 3. Okay, this also gives me 9. Right, that means if I multiply a positive number to itself two times, it gives me 9. Okay, so we saw how to find the square and square root of a number. Okay, but sometimes it becomes very difficult for us to find the square and square root of a number. Okay, if the number is very large or if the number is in decimals. Okay, like if there is a decimal point in a number. So in that cases, we can use a scientific calculator, and from this class onwards, this grade onwards, you are allowed to use a scientific calculator. So I will show how to find the square and square root of a number given to you by using a scientific calculator. Okay, so if I have to find the square root of a number, suppose 3.6. Okay, if I have to find the number, the square of a number 3.6. Okay, then how do we find the square of this number on a calculator? I will show you here. I don't have a calculator, but this is an app which I have downloaded on the phone. It works similar to a scientific calculator. Okay, so for now I will show you on this app. Okay, so if I have to find the square of this number 3.6, so what do? I press the numbers. First I press 3. Okay, then I press point, the point key, then 6, and then after that I press the key which is x square. Okay, and then equal to. Okay, so now here I'll show you 3. Now I have pressed point, 6, and then after that I will press this x square key. Okay, and equal to, the answer is 12.96. So from here we can, by the scientific calculator, we can directly find the answer. Okay, just by pressing the keys we immediately get the answer, get the square of any number. So this was a number which had a decimal point. By using the calculator we can find squares or square roots of any numbers which we want. Okay, let the number be very big also, we can find the square and square root of it. Okay, so okay, now if I have to find the square root of a number, okay, so if I have to find the square root of 16.81, okay, so if I have to find the square root of this number on the calculator, which keys do I press? First I press the square root key. Okay, then I press the numbers 16.81 and then equals to. Okay, so let us see what answer do I get. I press square root, then 16.81. Okay, so what is the answer? The answer is 4.1. Okay, so in this way you can get the squares and square roots of any numbers given to you. Okay, you can get the square of any number or the square root of any number by using a scientific calculator. Okay, now we will solve the exercise 1F. Okay, the sums of exercise 1F. Okay, so the first question is work out the square or square root. So you have to work out means you have to solve these sums by without using a calculator. Okay, so you have to work out the square. Wherever you have told to find the square of a number, you have to find the square, and wherever it is told to find the square root, we have to find the square root. Okay, so first sum we see, it is we have to find the square. Okay, the square of 9. So 9 square means what? 9 into 9. Okay, So 9 into 9 is how much? 9 9s are 81. Okay, so the square of 9 is 81. Okay, now the next square of 14. Okay, so 14 square means what? 14 multiplied by 14. Okay, so 14 into 14 is how much? 14 into 14 is, let's do it here. 14 into 14 is 4 4s are 16, 4 5, 4 1, 196. Okay, so 14 into 14 is 196. So we say that 196 is the square of 14. Okay, now we have to find the square root of 64. So which number multiplying by itself will give me 64? Which number by multiplying to itself gives me 64? Which number is it? It is 8. Okay, 8 into 8 is 64. So I write 8 multiplied by 8 is 64. Right? So, and this is plus or minus. So I write plus 8 or minus 8. And here also plus 8 or minus 8. So plus into plus 8 gives me plus 64, or minus into minus 8 gives me plus 64. Okay, so I write that the plus or minus square root of 64 is plus or minus 8. Okay, so this plus or minus 8 is the square root of 64. Okay, now the fourth one is plus or minus square root of 0. Now any number which number multiplied to itself will give me 0? 0 multiplied by itself only will give me 0, right? So if I multiply 0 to itself, it gives me 0. So the square root of 0 will be 0. And here there is no plus or minus. For 0, we don't have plus or minus. So the answer will only be 0. Okay? Now the next question. The second question is find the square or square root. You have to find the square root, square root of these numbers by using a calculator. You can use a calculator for these sums, or if you don't want to use the calculator, you can even solve it by hand. Okay, by yourselves. Okay, so let's find the squares and square roots of these numbers. Okay, we find the square and square root of these numbers. The first question is we have to find the square of 3.6. Okay, so by a calculator, I will first type 3.6 and then I press the x square button, x raised to 2. This gives me the answer, which is 12.96. So the square of 3.6 is 12.96. Okay, this is the answer. Now the second is 11.4 square. So I have to find the square of this number 11.4. So I press the key 11.4, and after that I press square. So this is 129.96. So this is the square root, the square of 11.4. Now in the third question, I have to find the square root of 0.16. Okay, so 0.16, let us find square root of 0.16 is equal to 0.4. Okay, so the square root of 0.16 is 0.4. But this is again positive or negative, so I put a positive or negative sign here. So the square root of plus or minus 0.16 is plus or minus 0.4. Okay, now the fourth one, plus or minus under root of square root of 0.64. Okay, so square root of 0.64 is equal to 0.8. Okay, so the square root is 0.8. Again, this is plus or minus, so we put a plus or minus sign. So the square root of 0.64 is either plus 0.8 or minus 0.8. Okay, so this is about finding square and square roots of a given number without using a calculator, as well as with using a calculator. Okay, now we go to the third question. The third question is find the square root of the following fractions. So these are the given fractions and we have to find the square roots of them. So whenever there is a square root given to the whole fraction, we can split the square root sign to both the numbers, that is the numerator and the denominator. Okay, so this, if after splitting the square root sign to the numerator and denominator, I can write it as under root of 16 divided by square root of 49. Okay, so here in this step I have splitted the square root sign for the numerator and the denominator. Okay, now simple, first check the numerator, it is 16. The square root of 16 we have to find. So what is the square root of 16? 4, right? 4 into 4 gives me 16. So the square root of 16 is 4. Okay, and similarly now we check the square root, just check the square root of the denominator. The denominator is square root of 49. So what is the square root of 49? Which number multiplied by itself gives me 49? 7, right? So the square root of 49 is 7. Okay, so the answer of the of this given question, that is square root, the whole square root of 16 and 49, 16 by 49 is 4 by 7. Okay, so this is our final answer. Okay, so 4 by 7 is the square root of 16 by 49. Now the next is 81, square root of 81 by 100. Similarly, here also we can split the square root sign to the numerator and the denominator. So after splitting, I write it as square root of 81 divided by square root of 100. Okay, so now what is the square root of 81? Square root of 81 is 9. 9 multiplied by 9 is 81. So the square root of 81 is 9. And the square root of 100 is? Which number multiplied by itself gives me 100? 10, right? So 10 into 10 is 100. So the square root of 100 is 10. So this is the final square root of the given question, under square root of 81 by 100. So this in this way we find the square roots of a given fraction. Okay, now the next question is, work out the following square roots without a calculator. We have to work out these square roots without using the calculator. So how do we do this? Okay, so how do we do this is, first we check the number. The number is 0.36. okay, and any number, if it is having a point in it, we can write the number as, we can write it as, this is which number? 0.36 means it is 36, right? Because 0 in front has no meaning. So I write only 36, and for this point I write powers of 10 down, right? That means here, after the point, after the decimal point, how many numbers are there? How many digits are there? There are 1, 2. So 2 digits. So if I put 2 zeros, so if I write it as 100, okay, 36 by 100, if I write 0.36 as 36 by 100, it is one and the same, right? It is one and the same, because 36 by 100, after dividing this, I get 0.36. okay, we have done this in you have done this in your previous classes, that how to write a given number if it is in decimal points, how do we write it in fraction form. Okay, so after writing this number in the fraction form, it becomes 36 by 100, and the square root sign is all over the fraction. Okay, so this is square root of 36 by 100. Now as we solved these sums, how to determine the square root of a fraction, we first split the square root sign. So this becomes a square root of 36 divided by square root of 100. Okay, now square root of 36 is, which number multiplied by itself gives me 36? 6. 6 into 6 is 36. So this is 6 divided by 100. Which number multiplied to itself is 100? 10, right? So this becomes 6 divided by 10. So this is in the fraction form. Again, we can convert this fraction into a decimal number. How do we convert? First, we write the number 6 as it is. Okay? Then how many zeros are there in the denominator? There is only one zero. So starting from the right and going to the left, I put a decimal point by counting one digit. Okay? So one digit to the left, I count and I put a point. Okay, so this becomes what? 0.6. So the fraction, the decimal form of this fraction 6 by 10 is 0.6. So I say that 0.6 is the square root of 0.36. So the square root of 0.36. The answer of this question is 0.6. Has everyone understood this? How to determine the square root of a number, of a decimal number, without a calculator? We can even do this without using a calculator. It is very simple. Okay. Now the next number. The next number is square root of 1.44. Okay. Now similarly, as we converted this decimal into a fraction, we can convert this decimal also into a fraction. So what we write? First we write the number as it is. The number is 1.44. Okay. We write the whole number without the decimal point. Then we count the number of digits. So how many digits are there after the decimal point? 1 and 2. Okay. So I write in the denominator 1 and 2 zeros. Okay. Now we put the square root sign. After putting the square root sign is for both, for the whole fraction. Okay. Now I split the square root sign. After splitting, it becomes what? Square root of 144 divided by the square root of 100. Okay. So now what is the square root of 144? Square root of 144 is 12. Okay. I tell you children that you must know the squares of numbers from 1 to 15 at least. Okay. That means what is the square of 1? 1 into 1 is 1. 2 into 2 is 4. 3 into 3 is 9. So in this way you write down all the squares of numbers from 1 to 15 and you have to memorize those numbers. Okay. Like 1 into 1 is, the square of 1 is 1. The square of 2 is 4. The square of 3 is 9. Okay. Like this you have to at least keep in mind the squares of numbers from 1 to 15. Okay. So the square root of 144 is 12 and the square root of 100 is again 10. So this becomes 12 by 10. Now again we have to convert this fraction into a decimal number. So first I write the number as it is, 12. I write 12. Now how many zeros are there in the denominator? There is only one zero. So starting from the right, I go to the left by counting the number of digits. Okay, so here there is only one zero. So I count only one digit from the left. So the decimal point will come here. Okay. So it becomes 1.2. So 1.2 is the final answer. Okay. So 1.2 is the square root of 1.44. Okay. So everyone has understood this, how to find the square root of a fraction, and then how we can find the square root of a decimal number also without using a calculator. Okay. Okay, students. Now we see the application of square and square root, okay, where this knowledge of square and square root is applied. So if I have a square, okay, so if this is a square, then what is the formula of the area of a square? We have done this. The formula of area of a square is side square. Okay, what is the side? The side. We know that all the sides of a square are same, right? This is also, if this is 5 centimeters, this will also be 5 centimeters. Okay, that means for a square, all the sides are same. And the area of the square, formula is what? Area of square is side square. So if the side of a square is given to us, then we can find the area of the square by squaring the side. Okay, so squaring the given side. Okay, so this is where the square is applied. Now, if the area is given to you, here if the side is given to you, you have to find the area. But if the area is given to you and if you have to find the side of the square, then what is the formula? Then we just have to put this square, we have to shift this square from this side to this side. So I told you after this, after going from one side to the other side of the equal to sign, it becomes a square root. Okay, so if I have to shift this, this becomes what? Under root, square root of area of square is equal to side. Okay, so by this formula we can find the side of the square if the area is given. Okay, so in simple words, if the side is given, if the side of a square is given to you, by squaring the side we can find the area. And if the area is given to you, by finding the square root of the area, we can find the side of the given square. Okay, so we will see a few sums based on this, how to find the area of the square if the side is given and how to find the side if the area is given. Okay. So the fifth question is, what is the area of a square with side length 3.2 meters? Okay, that means the side length of a square is given to you and we have to find the area. Okay, so as we now saw, the formula for area of a square is what? Area of square is side square, right? So the area will be equal to what? Side square. What is the side given to us? It is 3.2. okay, so 3.2 square. If we square 3.2, we will get the area of the given square. Okay, so 3.2 square means what? 3.2 multiplied by 3.2. okay, so how much is this? 3.2 into 3.2 is 10.24. okay, I have calculated this already. 3.2 into 3.2 gives me 10.24. okay, so this is the area of the square. Now how to determine the unit of area? Okay, now here you can see that side, the unit of the side is in meters, right? So if I put meters here, okay, so that means we have to square the meters, the unit also, right? So here 3.2 into 3.2 means 3.2 meters into 3.2 meters. So meter into meter will be what? Meter square. Okay, so this is the unit of area. The unit of length is meters and the unit of area is meter square. So the area of the given square is the area of the given square is 10.24 meter square. Okay, everyone has understood this. Now the next question, the sixth question is, what is the side length of a square with area 60.84 meter square? That means in this question the area is given to us and we have to find the side length. Okay, so as we saw here we saw that area of the square is side square, and if we want to find the side, if the area is given, then after interchanging these signs we get side length. The formula becomes side length is equal to square root of area of square. Okay, that means if the area is given to us, we can find the side length of the square by this formula. Okay, so what is the area given to us? 60.84. okay, so we have to square root this 60.84 meter square. Okay, meter square also I write. Now this becomes, the square root of 60.84 is 7.8. okay, so I have already calculated this, under square root of 60.84 is 7.8, so the answer is 7.8. now when we square root the meter square, okay, if I am writing this as square root of meter square, okay, that means if I am putting the square sign also and the square root sign also, why have I written meter square here? Because the area is given in meter square. Yes, the area unit, the unit of area is meter square, so I have written here meter square as it is. Okay, now if any number has the meter, the square sign as well as the square root sign, the square and the square root sign gets cancelled off. Okay, and only the unit remains. The unit is meter. Okay, so here the unit will be meters. Okay, so the side length of the given square is 7.8 meters. Okay, so has everyone understood what we have done in today's class? We have seen how to find the square and square root of a number, a normal whole number, as well as how to determine the square and square root of a decimal number. We can also use the calculator. And then after that, what we saw, we did a few sums. Then after that we saw how to find the square roots of fractions also and decimal numbers also without using a calculator. And then we saw how to find the area of a square if the side length is given, and how to find the side length if the area of the square is given to us. Okay, this was an application of square and square roots. Okay, so I hope everyone has understood today's class. So we will meet in the next class, students. Okay, till then, take care. Bye.